Oh, it's another Victory Monday, and today we are talking about a specific position on the Browns team.
Yeah, our Mike Polk Jr. gives his take on the big win yesterday and who he thinks deserves a lot of the credit.
Well, there's certainly a lot to celebrate on this Victory Monday. First and foremost being the victory, of course. I know we're new at winning, but I don't see this getting old anytime soon. As far as highlights, Kareem Hunt played out of his mind. We made a bunch of visiting meathead Chicago fan dudes really sad. I really like that. And of course, there's the fact that the defense managed to sack Bears quarterback Justin Fields. Wait, how many times?
9 times.
9 times.
That's a lot. But Kareem Hunt and Myles Garrett get plenty of praise, and deservedly so. Not only are they phenomenal talents, they also play high-profile, sexy positions that inevitably garner a lot of attention. That's why I've decided to devote my time here today to exclusively praising another standout performance from yesterday's game, someone who plays a position that too often goes overlooked. Today, I celebrate a kicker. That's right, I'm talking to you, Browns kicker Chance McMannan. Wait, that's not it, is it? What's his name?
Chase McLaughlin.
Right. I celebrate you, Chase McLaughlin. McLaughlin had a terrific game in which he made all 6 of his kicks, including 2 extra points and 4 field goals, 2 from beyond 50 yards. He also now holds the all-time record for longest field goal by a Browns kicker in that stadium after nailing a 57-yarder. Not bad for a day's work. Of course, we're gonna have to see some consistency out of this kid before we get too excited. The first thing he has to remember is that he is not Phil Dawson and never will be. Do you hear me? You will never be Phil Dawson. But that doesn't mean he can't have a meaningful and impressive career here in Cleveland if he manages to keep performing like he did yesterday. In fact, if everything goes well, perhaps he could even one day find himself featured on my personal Mount Rushmore of Cleveland Browns kickers. While he'll obviously never be able to displace Lou Groza, Phil Dawson, or Don Cockcroft, if he plays his cards right, there is a possibility that he could replace Scott Player, who only punted for the Browns for less than a month in 2007 before being released, but who earned his spot on my Browns kicker Rushmore simply by rocking the one-bar helmet and just looking awesome in general. But that spot is vulnerable and could be up for grabs. So there you have it, Jace McFadden, Chaz McNannon, Trace McSavage, Chase McLaughlin. Now you have something to aspire to. So keep it up, kid, and embrace your destiny by continuing to kick like you did in that game. And who knows, one day you might just earn yourself a spot on my totally subjective metaphorical mountain. And isn't that really what it's all about? This is Mike Polk, standing Phil Dawson forever for 3 News.